thank you very much for the invitation and the attention. I would like to start with a project in Shanghai. We have heard a lot about single skin, double skin facades comparisons and energy savings. And if you have a moderate climate like in Europe or here in this region of China, you can save a lot of energy by building an adaptive facade with an efficient sun shading design and with the option for natural ventilation. Because on a day like today, with temperatures of about 20 degrees outside, it would be perfect to have an office where you can open a window and ventilate naturally. It's also scientifically proven that the productivity of the employees is raising by as much as up to 20% if they feel in the position to have an influence on their office climate. So this is the compound for the Siemens Center, which is an high-rise of 14 stories. That's the main building. And then there are six others forming a campus-like office compound. And we have two facade types where we can focus on. This one here is the office facade, and this one here is a generous lobby facade. Close-up of these two types, the office facade and the lobby facade, they are very different. The office facade is a conventional, optimized double skin facade, and its main features are that it is 2.50 meters wide and 4 meters high, built in a unitized construction approach by facade company Shanghai. And you have always two axes of 1.25 meters with an opaque panel that you can open for cleaning and natural ventilation, and with a glazed operable window which you can open. The glazed one is a fixed glazing, so you open the opaque one, and all of it is shaded by a lamella louver system, which can be controlled by the user. Typically, it's operating from the automatic building control. The lamellas here at the slab edge are for air intake on the lower half and for air outlet on the upper half, so that there's a diagonal ventilation across each box. And the exhaust of hot air is not above or below, sorry, it's not below the air intake of the unit on top of it. Here you can see it a little bit better. This is the air intake. You see these perforations. And on the top of the unit, the air exhaust is on the other side. This is a photo of the first series production panel. You can see the size and the dimensions of the panel, 2.50 meters by 4 meters, very large glass pane being 10 square meter, very transparent outside appearance. And this is the air exhaust, because the intake is this is the air intake, and the exhaust is here. For the second facade type, the architects developed together with us a very transparent and generous lobby glazing. The lobby of the main entrance building is on three sides: this side, the front side, and the other side on the back of us in the picture. And you see that this facade is suspended only by cables, vertical cables, tensioned here in a height of 30 meters, and horizontal cables that run along the corner and these columns here in order to stabilize the deflections of the facade. The whole pane is again 4 meters high and 2.50 meters wide, and it's fixed only by these point fixings, so that a nearly completely transparent image is created. The construction is, first you put the cables hanging from top to bottom. These vertical cables are the main cables responsible for carrying the wind load. Then you apply pressure device in order to pre-tension the cables all the way down to their embed points, the anchorage points at the bottom. The elongation of the cable during the pre-stressing can be several centimeters. And then you get to a safe, fairly economic, and especially architecturally very transparent solution. A similar system has been applied, but on a even more, even a greater scale to a project in Vietnam. And in Vietnam, this technique was entirely new to the country, so we had to not only develop the system, but also to kind of supervise the implementation and advise on the technical installation. It's a high-rise for the Ministry of Internal Affairs. There's a unitized single-skin facade on top, and two sides, this one, the back side and the front side of the lobby, underneath the high-rise, sitting on these two blocks of core shaft, with a 35-meter tall and nearly 50-meter wide, very transparent cabinet facade. Again, how it is pre-stressed, first install the vertical cables. They are suspended from the steel truss, which is also carrying the high-rise atop. So the weight of all these floors here atop is much more than the tension force in the cable, and the truss wouldn't even notice the pre-tensioning of the cable. Then they are pre-tensioned at the bottom, this time with a pressuring device here and a kind of lever arm to pull it down here, so that finally, after pre-tensioning the cable, you can insert the bolt here. Then you apply the glazing, and then you come to a even more transparent solution than the one here in Shanghai, because the size of the elements is slightly smaller. And you must imagine this one is only half of the cable facade, because of the standpoint of the photographer, it's two times as high as you see here on the photo. I like this photo very much. The rest of the building compound of 300,000 square meters, the low-rise buildings and the rest of the high-rise are clad with the unitized facade elements. And the whole compound looks like this in the end. If you think the motif of cable facade further, we arrive to very technically demanding and innovative solutions. And this building here is in New City Lingang, close to Shanghai, here southward. It's a museum for maritime naval exhibition. And it basically consists of two 50-meter high sails with two anti-plastic two-way curved cable facades in between. So technically, it's a high-rise because 50 meter is something. This is a look of the building with these two cable facades, this one and the one behind, and these two three-dimensionally curved shells clad with aluminum panels. Close up. The structure is the main structure of the building, of the very generous space, is a truss system hidden into these solid sails, where you only have, for the whole 50-meter sail, you only have one, two, three support points. So three points, the one at the bottom at the foundation, and the third one here where the two sails are leaning against each other in one single point. So that's very challenging. And the entire space is clad in that way. And here you can see the two-dimensionally curved, anti-classic curved cable net facades. The installation has been done by a Chinese construction company. And this is the scaffolding, which is the masterpiece of engineering itself, if you ask me. The worker here shows the scale of the building. The solid elements have been clad with metal deck and with a substructure, and the aluminum cladding, the white cladding, has been applied to that substructure. the curved two-way cable net facade is made of four corner panels which have point fixings. All around, the point fixings look like this, and have been designed like most of the design customized for the project. And here you can see how these two layers of cables are fixed together in one single point, which is also carrying the glass panels. Close up. This was something that was special in three-dimensional design. But you can even push the three-dimensionality further, because this building, cultural center of the, it's in the capital of Azerbaijan in Baku, designed by Zaha Hadid architects, is an entirely three-dimensional surface where no single point is equal to the next one. So it's a complete freeform NURBS shape. And the solutions developed for that building had to be customized and engineered from scratch. So the three-dimensional building envelope structure has been designed as a space frame. This is a unitized structural element where you can design and engineer the bars and cut them in a CNC cutting machine directly from the computer program, so that this is the basis for the freeform surface. Then there were these gray areas are waterproofing trays, meaning metal deck insulation and waterproofing membrane, all installed to the space frame. And then there's an array of unique member substructure to these white GRC and GRP panels. These are a few shots of the installation of the panel going on. The panels are all uniquely molded. They have been molded, each of them unique. None of them is existing two times on the building, so there's a mold, you pull the panel and throw the mold away. The size of these panels is between, it's up to 7 meters long and about 1.60 meters wide. Another photo of the installation of the cladding in progress. Interior skin is a three-dimensionally curved special gypsum board structure. This is a photo of the auditorium with a three-dimensionally curved wooden structure. Photo of the building at nighttime and daytime. Talking about 3D design, we have also consulted the curtain wall to the Baku Flame Towers. It's a mixed-use three tower development also in Baku. And these three towers have a shape like flames. And this shape was initially designed by an NURBS shape from HRK London architect. And we modified that shape with simplifying the geometry in order to be able to clad the entire project with four-corner flat glazed facade elements. So we analyzed the building shape and rebuilt it with cylindrical and conical curved elements with steady transitions, so that you wouldn't see much of a difference. But the major advantage is that it is not necessary anymore to use triangularization. You can see the installation of these four-corner elements in progress. There's also a huge special flick structure atop. It's a kind of benchmark piece for international design and sourcing, because for that project, like for many projects we have nowadays, the construction site is here. Facade supplier was Schüco, facade system supplier Schüco. Here, that's our base. Prototype testing and architects were here. Facade units have been assembled in a plant in the middle of Turkey. The facade contractor shop design and procurement was in Istanbul. The glass came from the United Arab Emirates. So that's how the projects are handled today. The facade units have been pulled up in the elevator shaft and then mounted from outside. And the project is in, the facade installation is near completion now. If you visit that country, you can see especially a very beautiful LED nighttime dynamic installation, where the whole towers are used as a projection screen to create moving images. We have a couple of projects ongoing in China with innovative facade systems. One of them is the Nanjing Tower, where groundbreaking has been done approximately 1 year ago. It's a 400-meter tall tower with a unitized single-skin curtain wall with a flap at the bottom and a cantilevering outer plane in order to provide convenient natural ventilation, shielded and without draft effects. And the podium here is very interesting. It's a free-form, three-dimensional structure with unique stainless steel shading elements. The other one ongoing is a three-tower development here in Shanghai in the financial center. Each of the three towers has a kind of standard office curtain wall and two generous cable facade, more than 100 meter high lobby glazing, all connected with a giant two-story bridge. And the unitized office facade is the of that type that we have called active facade earlier, meaning that there's an insulated glass outside, then the sun shading runs in the cavity, and there's a monoglass, operable monoglass inside, and the hot air collected at the sun shade will be extracted by the HVAC system. The specialty is that we have an architecturally motivated recess here, which is clad with stainless steel corrugated panel. And we have operable windows at the bottom in order to let fresh air in. There were mock-ups constructed for this project, showing an impression of the verticality and the design here. And these are external stainless steel fins. The detailing is that the there's a kind of male mullion with the major stiffening of the entire system and a female mullion, so a unitized split system, so that the stainless steel cladding can be continuous and good looking. And this is a vertical section with a section of the operable window. These are close-ups of the mock-ups for the operable window. It works like this, and you see how the operable window kind of bypasses the double-skin rest of the facade, where the insulated outer plane and the monopane inside provide a cavity where the sunshade is located in, and where there's an efficient control of the heat. For the detailing, this is a beautiful detailing approach from the mock-up by facade company Yuanda. You see how with a little care to the hinges and the detailing, you can create a very beautiful facade impression. That's all I wanted to tell you. Thank you very much for listening.